Governor Rauner signed legislation allowing state health insurance and Medicaid coverage for abortions in Chicago. News Equifax. News Next, the first Weather Channel forecast.
Dropping to 57 and clearing in windy on Friday with a high near 69 degrees. Then during the weekend, a mix of clouds and sunshine with highs staying in the mid to upper 60s. From the Weather Channel, I'm Jeff Marr, WLS AM 890, with another update in 30 minutes.
It's 72 degrees in Chicago. Republican Governor Bruce Rauner has signed legislation that would provide state health insurance and Medicaid coverage for abortions. The General Assembly controlled by Democrats approved the measure in May, but delayed sending it to Rauner until Monday, in part because he has changed his mind about support of the plan. As a candidate in 2014, Rauner said he would support expanding coverage for abortions, but last April, he said he opposed the idea and said the state should focus on improving the economy. Rauner was asked if his wife influenced his decision.
I have relied on dozens and dozens of people who I respect. I'm certainly the first lady. I talk to the first lady every day on many topics. She's my best friend.
The legislation also removes language in Illinois law that states a desire to criminalize abortion if 1973 U.S. Supreme Court ruling legalizing the procedure is overturned. At Chicago City Hall, Bill Cameron says Mayor Emanuel and Alderman Ed Burke have filed a City of Chicago lawsuit against Equifax for its massive data breach.
It's a consumer fraud lawsuit that seeks billions of dollars in damages because Equifax supposedly failed to protect your personal financial information and then took months to notify you about it. And Chairman of Finance Ed Burke wants something else.
The CEO of this company is about to qualify for a $90 million golden parachute.
He doesn't want that parachute to open. Equifax is expected to argue, hey, we got hacked, and we did the best we could. And City Hall Bill Cameron, WSAM 890.
Someone tapped into some Whole Foods systems and got credit card info. CNBC says it was information from cards used in tap rooms and full table service restaurants in some of the grocery chain stores. Those venues use a different system than the main Whole Foods checkout systems. Whole Foods says an investigation is ongoing and it will provide information as it is available. Twitter has told Congress that some 200 Russia-linked accounts tried to interfere in the 2016 presidential election by spreading misinformation. The Senate has confirmed former GOP presidential candidate and Utah Governor John Huntsman to be the U.S. ambassador to Russia. He has previously served as ambassador to China and Singapore. And a standing ovation today for Congressman Steve Scalise as he returned to Capitol Hill for the first time since a gunman opened fire at a GOP baseball practice in June. Scalise says he is a living example that miracles really do happen. He was shot in the hip, suffered internal injuries, underwent a few surgeries, and received a warm welcome as he used two canes to walk onto the House floor today.
When I was laying out on that ball field, the first thing I did once I was down and I couldn't move anymore is I just started to pray. And I will tell you, it gave me an unbelievable sense of calm, knowing that at that point it was in God's hands.
And he says God delivered. The House Republican whip is planning to resume his Capitol Hill job while continuing outpatient rehabilitation. As for the Belleville, Illinois man who shot Scalise, he was killed by police after shooting five people. Julia Louis-Dreyfus says one in eight women get breast cancer, and today she's the one. The 56-year-old Beat star says she received the diagnosis the day after she won an Emmy for Best Actress in a Comedy Series on September 17th. HBO, which renewed the show for a seventh season, says it will adjust the production schedule as needed. WLS News Time, 5:04, time for traffic. Eaton's right now out to Lake Cook 25 minutes, inbound from Lake Cook 45. The Kennedy out to the junction 40 to O'Hare 1 hour. Inbound O'Hare to downtown an hour 10, junction in 30. Eisenhower out to Wolf at 50 to Thorndale at hour 10. Inbound Thorndale to the Vern an hour 15, Wolf in 50. Stevens Head out to the Tri-State an hour 5. Inbound to the Veterans Toll, that's now an hour 17. Inbound from the Veterans Toll 55, Tri-State in 35. And the Dan Ryan out to 95th at 35, 95th in a half hour. Our next traffic update in 15 minutes. News on the hour, the half, and when it breaks. Continuous coverage at WLSAM.com. More of the Steve Dahl Show on the way. Our next report at 5:30. I'm Jennifer Kuiper, WLSAM 890 News.
This hour is sponsored by AccountTabs. In today's economy, highly skilled accounting and finance professionals can be hard to find. As the leader in specialized temporary staffing, AccountTabs provides top accounting and finance talent where and when you need it the most. Visit AccountTabs.com. AccountTabs, a Robert Half company.
Do you think your home may have a structural foundation problem? For a free inspection and diagnosis, call PermaSeal at 800-421-SEAL or visit PermaSeal.net.
Don't mess for me and better PermaSeal. owner who needs working capital to help grow and support your business? Do you know where the money is going to come from? Have you been turned down from a local bank? If you need working capital and need it now, call Strategic Funding. We provide up to $1 million in alternative financing to retailers, restaurants, hotels, and hundreds of different types of businesses. Unlike getting financing through a bank, our unique financing services are very flexible, with repayment plans customized to meet your needs. Our underwriting is extremely fast, allowing approval in as little as 1 day. It's totally stress-free. If you've been in business for at least a year, have an annual revenue of $150,000 or more with a minimum credit score of 550, pick up the phone and call now for a free, no-obligation consultation to see what you qualify for. Dial 800-216-9927. 800-216-9927. That's 800-216-9927. I challenge you to